It's really important as you know what normal looks like and you can identify normal structures. Because if you can do that, you can then identify what's abnormal and then make plans depending on what's going on. It's really important to know your anatomy so you know how to manipulate to enhance the view. For example, that vellicular, that the bottom of the epiglottis, it's this fibrous area, and by pushing into that, the epiglottis flips up and allows you to see a better view of the larynx. You may have heard of a maneuver called Selleck's maneuver or cricoid pressure. Now, because the cricoid ring is the only complete ring, if people apply the correct amount of pressure in the correct way, downwards or posteriorly, that complete ring theoretically can obstruct the esophagus. Now, it's really important to know the tracheal length. So the average tracheal length is about 10 to 12 centimeters in an adult. And that means that when you pass the endotracheal tube through the cords, you don't want to go too far. If you were to go too far, it'd go down one bronchus, usually the right side, which means that you'll be ventilating only the right lung, which is half the oxygenation that you could potentially give this patient.